Good evening, friends. Today we'll talk on the ovarian age. So we all know that age is age, it's a chronological age, it doesn't change. But what changes is the physical age or the aging of different tissues. So chronological age and a physical age is now a well-established concept. As we know, chronological age is the age by birth. If the child is born on this date and after 1 year, he will be of 1 year of age. Similarly, after 30 years, he will be of 30 years of age. But when we see three different persons of 30 years of age, all do not look the same, all do not feel the same, all do not have the same physical, mental, emotional capacity. So this is the difference between chronological age and the physical age. So sometimes when you see three different persons of the 30 years age, some may look like 25, some may look like 30, and some may look like 35. So this doesn't mean that age changes, but sometimes the body function changes. Now more and more people are becoming health conscious and they do regular diet and exercise, and sometimes they feel because they can work the same as 30 year old, that doesn't mean that even if they are 40 years old, their physical age is 30. Because both the ages are important, chronological age as well as the physical age, for the final health well-being of the individual. So physical age depends on many factors. It depends on your genetics, how you take care of your body, the environment, etc. So again, the age affects different organs differently. Sometimes you see some people may get diabetes first, hypertension first, arthritis first. So it depends on susceptibility of the various organs based on the genetics and the additional factors of the lifestyle that adds up to the disease. So we see that physical age and the chronological age are two different things. Similarly, because most of the diseases of lifestyle origin, they come at a later age, but ovarian age is different because the lifespan of the ovary or the reproductive years are not the same as your lifespan. So because the female has a limited reproductive years, a male can become a father even at the age of 70 with his own sperm. However, if we talk about female, she cannot become a mother with her eggs beyond certain age, beyond 45 years. It is very rare to conceive with her own eggs. So female has a limited lifespan of, let's say, 15 to 45 years, and the ideal age is what we say is 20 to 40 years to conceive. So ovarian function stops at menopause. So when you stop getting period, that is the time the ovarian function is stopped. However, it becomes erratic around 5 to 10 years before the menopause. So you, at the age of 40, if you have regular cycles, but the age of the oocytes are not the same as the 30 years age. So as the age increases, the oocyte quality decreases, the DNA of the oocyte is not as good with aging, and so with advanced age, more and more embryos are genetically abnormal or functionally abnormal. So it is important to understand the ovarian aging. It is not the same as the physical aging. Now there are various studies which have compared Indian women with Caucasian women looking for the ovarian reserve, and we have seen that the Indian women have a lesser ovarian reserve compared to the Caucasian women. Now how to determine the ovarian age? It is mainly a medical diagnosis, means you need to see a doctor, but still there are many warning signs. First, it's the chronological age is the basis on which the doctor or any person will evaluate. Suppose if you are 50 years of age, now no matter how good your ovary looks, it is impossible to conceive, practically impossible to conceive with your own eggs. Similarly, if you are 20 and your ovaries don't look 20, they look very poor, but still you have a good chance of conceiving with your own eggs. So chronological age is very important. Apart from that, sometimes cycle regularity also gives us a good clue, because if the cycles are regular and their average length is good, let's say 20 to 32 days, there is very less chance of poor ovarian reserve. Similarly, if the cycle irregularity is late onset, it gives us a more clue that it is maybe because of poor ovarian reserve. At the same time, you need to rule out other problems such as common problems of PCOS. If there are short menstrual cycles, that is again a clue that there may be a poor ovarian reserve. Apart from this history and age, there are other blood tests such as the AMH test, anti-Müllerian hormone test, which can determine the ovarian age. And similarly, a sonography, the antral follicles, the number of follicles we see in the ovary, a good fertility expert can determine the ovarian age from the sonography also. Similarly, as I talked about the face, same applies for the ovary. So if we see three ovaries of 30 years of age, they don't look the same. Some may look like 25, some may look like 30, and some may look like 35. So when we do a scan, when you get a scan done, it is important to know the number of follicles and whether the ovary corresponds with your age or not. So ovary should not be just normal or abnormal. It should be, it should correspond to the age. So now, what will be the ideal age for fertility? So if you talk of the chronological age, the best age to conceive child is below 30. Above 30, as the age advances, the problems of pregnancy and childbirth also increases, the chance of fertility declines. However, there is not a very significant difference or very fast decline between 30 to 35 years of age. But after 35 years of age, the fertility declines rapidly and there is an increase in chance of miscarriage and chromosomally abnormal childbirth. So it is important to conceive fast if the age is above 35 years. But for the patients having age between 30 to 35 years, if the ovarian reserve or the ovarian age is high, then it's a warning sign and you should try to get partner and become pregnant faster. So if, as I said, if the age is less than 30, then if you don't have any symptoms, you don't need to worry. You don't have irregular cycles, you don't have short cycles, or you don't have any family history of early menopause, then you don't need to worry. If your age is 30 to 35 years and you have symptoms, you must worry and get an evaluation done. And in any case, it is better to conceive between 30 to 35. But if the ovarian reserve is less, then you should plan pregnancy more faster. And if the age is more than 35, even the chronological age is more than 35, then it is always better to get pregnant faster. So now the question is, what to do? How can I know? What should I do? So the best answer is, when in doubt, check. If it is good, then it will be reassuring. And if it is not good, then you will know the diagnosis and you will know your timeline, and then in that case you should try to get pregnant faster. As we know, there is no cure for aging. So if the reserve is less, then there are no medicines which will magically work and improve the ovarian reserve. There are many eyewash type supplements which can temporarily help, but relying on it and delaying fertility is not at all advisable. And if you are in a position that you cannot conceive and your ovarian aging is fast, in that case you have the option of preserving your oocytes. So that is a technique by which we stimulate the ovaries, collect the oocytes and freeze them, and we can use them later. The advantage is that whatever reserve you have today, we can get more number of oocytes. We have the quality of a younger age oocyte when we want to use them. The disadvantage is that it is not a 100% treatment option. So you can know more about freezing by contacting us. And as I said, that if you are having age of more than 30 to 35 and you have any symptoms of cycle irregularity, short cycles, and you are facing difficulty in conceiving, you should consult a fertility expert as soon as possible. Thank you so much for joining me today. We'll see you again next time.